So guys, as we get into the year of 2025, lots of big things are happening, especially this year where everything is taken to the next level. Lots of advancement in self-driving technology, in the development of newer vehicles, and especially in the battery technology that's going into future products. And of course, with Tesla being at the forefront of everything, they are preparing to release one of the biggest updates to any vehicles we've ever seen before, and that is going to be on the batteries. According to an interview published by The Information, Tesla plans to introduce four new types of 4680 batteries that will power its future vehicles, starting with the Cybertruck, the Robotaxi Cybercab, the Model 3, and the Model Y. The batteries are scheduled to enter production in 2026, allowing Tesla to qualify for any future federal incentives that mandates sourcing material domestically. Additionally, the new batteries will reduce Tesla's dependence on outsourced cells from suppliers like LG, Panasonic, BYD, and Cathay. This shift will alleviate current battery constraints, cutting shipping costs, and enable Tesla to lower vehicle prices overall. The four cells that Tesla plans to introduce in 2026 has been confirmed to come with temporary code names. All new battery packs will be labeled NC, which stands for new cells, and with the remaining digits indicating specific vehicles or products they are designed for. However, this naming convention is expected to be updated over time to better align with the products they support. To start off, there's the NC05 cells, designed to be an easy-to-manufacture option. This cell will power the Cybercab and also expected to be used in Tesla's upcoming low-cost $25,000 model, anticipated to arrive sometime next year. The next size up is the NC20. This is designed to power Tesla's SUV and the Cybertruck. This larger format cell is designed for heavier vehicles and may be optimized for towing, addressing challenges the Cybertruck currently faces with its existing 4680 cells, particularly in towing with harsh weather conditions. Finally, the NC30 and the NC50 cells, though categorized together, will be produced using separate manufacturing processes. They will be built using distinct material that will operate differently from the standard cells used in the lower lineups. These advanced cells are expected to drive major advancement in both faster charging times and improved energy output. The design will greatly enhance energy transfer and is set to play a huge role in Tesla's goal of ultra-fast supercharging capabilities. Now with that, Tesla has been working in the background at Giga Texas to build these 4680 cells, and they are going to be prioritizing the Model 3s and Model Ys. These are the vehicles that will probably qualify for future potential incentives. These are the ones that they need to source materials domestically and make it possible to receive all of these grants. Now, not only that, but by manufacturing these batteries in-house, they can avoid issues like markups and conflicts with suppliers. All of this is going to play a huge role in their vertical integration and is going to be a big driver in push in making everything work as one, software to hardware to battery. All of this is going to play a huge component in driving the sales of Tesla. In other news, an analyst of the China supply value chain suggests that Tesla is set to begin production of its affordable car known as the Model 2 at Giga Shanghai in Q3 of 2025. The South Korean analyst has indicated that the vehicle will likely feature a steering wheel inspired by the Robotaxi design, while offering the space, practicality, and features of the Model 3. In addition to everything else, Tesla is also planning an even larger vehicle that could potentially surpass the Model Y sales by a significant margin, including the upcoming compact version that they are currently working on. Currently, Tesla offers the Model X and Model Ys as family options, and the Model X features 3-row seatings and accommodates up to 7 passengers, but it is also the most expensive vehicle in Tesla's entire lineup. The Model Y offers 7-seat configuration as well, but a smaller 3rd row is primarily used for younger children, making it less ideal for larger families. This creates a huge gap in Tesla's lineup, giving the company an opportunity in the minivan market. Now, it seems like Tesla is looking to fill this gap very soon, as based on 2 separate exchanges on X between Elon Musk and Tesla owners with larger families. In the first exchange, a user expressed frustration that the Model X just wasn't spacious enough for their family and brought up the idea of a big Tesla for big families. And Elon responded, as he often does, with a simple okay. Now, the best part about this is, in a later exchange with a user that has a family of 9, Elon confirmed that they are definitely working on the RoboVan It is in development, although they are also working on some other things. This could mean that they could be working on a minivan or some sort of SUV that is going to be a cross between the Model Y and Model X. It's just going to be more spacious in the back row, but also not as big and not as expensive. This is why 2025 is going to be the most exciting year of the past few. This is going to be the year that every new vehicle that they've ever planned for is going to be announced or going to be unveiled. This is going to be the year where full self-driving is going to go unsupervised. And this is going to be the year where we are going to see a massive gain in technology in terms of the battery development. 500 miles on a full charge, that is what we are after. Now, just going back to my original point, if you are in the market for a new Model Y Juniper and you are so excited to order one right now, although it might be beneficial to go for the launch series, there are also other benefits why you should wait off. But there's also the fact that Hardware 5 is on the horizon, and the new battery that Cathode is working on, as well as the 4680 cells, these are eventually going to go into the newer Model Y Junipers sometime later this year. And this is where you're going to cross that 400 mile per charge mark, and that's going to be the sweet spot, the perfect vehicle that you're ever going to want. And before we head off, I do have one question for you guys. Would you rather wait 5 to 6 months for the newer battery to come out, or would you rather wait an entire year to 2026 to get the full-on package of Hardware 5 as well as the battery? Or are you planning to just pick up one right now as soon as it's available? That is something I'm really questioning. I'd love to hear your thoughts on it. Let me know in the comments below. All of us are probably on the same boat. So yeah, that's definitely something to consider. I know that the range is a big part that drives you to buy a Tesla and the superchargers, of course, but this is all going to be a huge upgrade coming up. So definitely wait out for that. Of course, I will be keeping a close eye on every little thing that comes up. As soon as I hear more about this 4680 cell or the cathode batteries, I will be updating you as quickly as possible. But anyways, this should wrap it up for this one. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, you know what to do. This is John once again. Peace out.